गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, दिस इज शर्मिला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, भारत यूनिवर्सिटी, बेंगलुरु। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द बायो एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट। द टॉपिक इज एंटरप्रेन्योर्स एंड देयर इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन बायोटेक्नोलॉजिकल इंडस्ट्री। वॉट इज एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप? The best way to predict the future is to create it. Peter Drucker. The Indian biotechnology industry is one of the fastest growing knowledge-based sectors. India currently ranks amongst the top 12 biotechnology destinations in the world and is a global leader in the production of drugs and vaccines. For an economy like India, the biotechnology is a powerful enabling technology that can revolutionize agriculture, healthcare, industrial processing, and environment sustainability. Okay, what is entrepreneurship? The entrepreneurship can be described as a process of action an entrepreneur undertakes to establish his enterprise. Entrepreneurship is a creative activity. It is the ability to create and build something from practically nothing. It is a knack of sensing opportunity where others see chaos, contradiction, and confusions. Then, the entrepreneurship is the attitude of mind seek opportunities. Another definition we can give like this: the entrepreneurship is the attitude of mind seek opportunities, take calculated risk and derive benefits by setting up a venture. It comprises of numerous activities involved in conception, creation and running an enterprise. According to Peter Drucker, the entrepreneurship is defined as a systematic innovation which consists in the purposeful and organized search for changes. And it is the systematic analysis of the opportunities such changes might offer for economic and social innovation. So that the entrepreneurship is defined as a systematic innovation which consists in the purposeful and organized search for changes. According to the forecast by the Association of Biotechnology Lead Enterprises, ABLE, that is the Association of Biotechnology Led Enterprises, the Indian biotechnology industry sector has the potential to be $100 billion, that is rupees 6 lakh crore industry in the next decade. The Indian biotechnology industry can be broadly classified into 5 categories, namely biopharmaceuticals, bioagriculturals, bioservices, bioindustry, and bioinformatics. There are approximately 800 to 850 large, from a medium and small startup companies in the biotechnology and allied sectors. Within the different sectors in biotechnology, there are multiple disciplines which are huge specialties on their own. So that is the four categories, biopharmaceuticals, bioagriculture, bioservices, and bioindustries and biopharmaceuticals. The biopharma, that is, it comes under drugs, vaccines, and diagnostics. Then, if you take bioindustrial, that is biofuel, nutraceuticals, and then enzymes. Then if you go for bioagri, that is hybrid crops, biopesticides, biofertilizers. Then bioservices, custom synthesis and manufacturing and contract research. And these are the comes under the bioservices, custom synthesis and manufacturing and contract research. Then bioinformatics, data analytics, and software database services. So next we can see that is India is an advantageous position to harness the potential of biotechnology due to its unique strength, such as availability of rich bioresources, technical expertise, skilled manpower, progressive government policies, and rapidly expanding access to international markets. So that the India is in advantageous position to harness the potential of biotechnology due to its unique strength, availability of rich bio resources and technical expertise. The promotion of the Indian biotechnology sector is high on the policy agenda of the Government of India. The biotechnology has been recognized as one of the key priority sectors under the Make in India and Skill India and Startup India. So, the biotechnology has been recognized as one of the key priority sectors, that is Make in India, Skill India, and Startup India. Initiative of the Government of India, being one of the few sectors on strong growth trajectory to drive sustainable economic growth and generate the large scale employment opportunities. The DBT, National Biotechnology Development Strategy 2015 to 2020, it provides a strategic roadmap for India's emergence as a global biotechnology innovation, and it is used for the manufacturing hub and contribute towards enterprise creation, innovation, and economic growth. For that, the DBT, that is National Biotechnology Development, the strategy that is provides a strategic roadmap for India's emergence. In order to achieve the $100 billion target of the Indian biotech industry, there is a crucial need to strengthen the existing biotech industry as well as a create new biotech industries. So that the DBT, that is the National Biotechnology Development, it provides the strategy for roadmap for India's emergence. The entrepreneurship based on innovation has immense growth potential. Given this context, encouraging and promoting self-employment as a career option for young people will be of highest importance. Most policymakers and academics agree that entrepreneurship is critical to the development and well-being of society. Most policymakers and academics agree that the entrepreneurship is critical to the development and well-being of society. The entrepreneurs drive and shape innovations. So, for that new innovation, they are important for this thing, thereby speeding up structural changes in the economy. The entrepreneurship is thus a catalyst for economic growth. They will promote the economic growth, the total Indian economic growth and in national competitiveness. So they are that entrepreneurship, they play an important role in that economy, okay, economic growth and the national competitiveness. An entrepreneur is a person. Okay, who will become an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is a person who starts an enterprise. That's all. An entrepreneur is someone who perceives opportunity, organizes resources needed for exploiting that opportunity and exploits it. So that the entrepreneur is a person, anyone can become entrepreneur. For that, no need to study, no need to get a degree, etc., etc. An entrepreneur is a person who starts an enterprise. An entrepreneur is someone who perceives the opportunity, that is important. Okay, what are the characteristics of an entrepreneur? In this characteristics of an entrepreneur, it include spontaneous creativity, the ability and willingness to make decisions in the absence of solid data, and a generally risk-taking personality. An entrepreneur may be driven by a need to create something new or build something tangible. So the entrepreneur, they are always thinking to become, to achieve this success, as well as an entrepreneur may be driven by a need to create something new. They will implement the new ideas. They will share the new ideas to implement that innovations. So that an entrepreneur may be driven by a need to create something new or build something tangible. The process of entrepreneurship. Although enterprises are different and unique, as the entrepreneurs who create them, most of them appear to work through a process. These are the learning technique, that is self-discovery. Learning what they enjoy doing. Examining their strength and weakness. They have to analyze, they have to understand their strength and weaknesses. What are the strengths they are having and what are the weakness? The entrepreneurship is always, that is the learning process to achieve the goal and success. So learning what they enjoy doing, examining their strength, they have to analyze their strength, what are the strengths they are having, and weaknesses also they have to analyze. So then only they can correct. Okay. So examining work experience and relating to potential opportunities. Identifying opportunities. So in the previous slides, that is, they have to analyze their strengths and weaknesses of their own. If it is, their strength should be increased, and then the weakness that should be eliminated. Then here, identifying opportunities, looking for needs, whatever we want. Whatever the problem is arising, that should be solved. And challenges that are not yet being met or dealt effectively. This is the identifying opportunities. Looking for needs, problems, and challenges that are not yet being met or dealt effectively. Then generating and evaluating ideas. Using creativity and past experience to devise new and innovative ways to solve a problem or meet a need, and then narrowing the field to one best idea. Whatever they are getting the best ideas, that should be they will put into the industries. Okay, then the ideas, the solve the problems, how to, once if the problem comes, they will find that they innovate the ways to solve the problems. That is generating and evaluating the ideas for the better achievement. Next is planning. Planning is very, very important for each one of our lives. Okay, we should have the plan. Even if it is studying, we should have a plan. Even if you are going for business, we should have a plan. Whatever we are going for, even purchasing also, we should have some plan. Then only we can work accordingly. Okay, so researching and identifying resources needed to turn the idea into a viable venture. Doing the research in the form of a written business, the plan, preparing the marketing strategies. But here we can see that the marketing strategies, that is the planning. Okay, once if it is the we can analyze and understand and then implement that whatever the problem is coming in the market. Once if it is down and fall, I mean if it is any prices is increased or down, listen, accordingly we have to sell the product. That is the marketing strategies. In the research, doing the research in the form of a written business plan, preparing marketing strategies. Raising startup capital using the business, the plan to attract investors, venture capitalists and partners. This stage can involve producing prototypes or test marketing services. What is a startup? That launching the venture, developing a customer base and adjusting the marketing and operational plans as required. This is startup. So in that bio entrepreneurship, the very, very important point that we have to see, that is startup. Launching the venture, developing a customer base. Customer base means we need to satisfy the customers. Whatever they want, that we have to give, we have to solve. If they complain any problem, we have to solve the problems, etc. And one more thing, that is adjusting marketing and operational plans as required. Next is growth. What is growth? Growth is very, very, in general, if you say, the growth is very, very important for every, even in that child, the growth is important. In the plant, that is, growth is important. Any crop, the growth is important. And then the business, that growth is very, very important. So the growth, the word is very, very important for everything. That is a better name. The growth, growing the business, developing and following strategy plans, adapting to new circumstances. So that is the growth. If they started the business, developing and following the strategic plan, developing the strategic plan, whatever the new techniques, the new ideas that should be put into the plant, and then they have to adapt in new circumstances. If they are going for new phases, new stage, that they have to adapt the circumstances, that the environment, the people, those who are around in the business, that is adapting to new circumstances. This thing only for growth, for common for everything, all the businesses, but that for developing new businesses, adapting new environment and new circumstances is very, very essential. Then harvest. Whatever we are doing, we will expect one for the harvest. We will always expecting the harvesting time, right? So the same way, even the business people, I mean that entrepreneurship also, selling the business and harvesting the rewards. The rewards. And for many entrepreneurs, this also means moving on to the new venture and new challenges. Then, the entrepreneurial role that encompasses the following responsibility. What are the responsibility for their entrepreneurial role? Perception of market opportunities. The second one, gaining command over scarce resources. Purchasing inputs. That marketing the products, that is very important. Even all the points are important in this entrepreneurial role. Then dealing with bureaucrats. So each and every point that we are looking is very much important. Perception of market opportunities, gaining command over scarce resources, purchasing inputs, marketing the products, and dealing with bureaucrats. Managing human relations within the firm. Then managing customer and supplier relationship. That is also very important. Managing finance. So this is each and every steps is also important. Managing finance. The production department, managing the production. Acquiring and overseeing assembly of the factory. Then industrial engineering. Upgrading process and product. Introducing new production technique and products. Okay. So, perception of market opportunities, gaining command, purchasing inputs, marketing the product, dealing with bureaucrats, managing the human relationship with the firm and the customer relationship, then managing the finance, managing the production, then overseeing assembly of the factory, industrial engineering, upgrading process and product. The final, that last one, that is introducing the new production technique and product. So whatever the new techniques that should be put into that for the venture. Then competencies of an entrepreneur, the entrepreneurial values and attitudes, it provide the necessary backdrop for acquiring the sense of enterprise. It is, however, necessary that a budding entrepreneur should have the necessary competencies so that he or she can venture into an enterprise. The competency is a set of defined behavior that provide a structured guide enabling the identification, evaluation, and development of the behaviors in an individual. The entrepreneurial competencies are certain basic competencies to be acquired by an entrepreneur. They relate to the type of behavior exhibited in the performing of various tasks in the discharge of his functions. Some of these competencies are latent in the entrepreneur, which need to be identified, nursed, and nurtured. Others are acquired through training and practices. The entrepreneurial competencies can be classified under the categories, that is, initiative. First one, initiative. One of the most fundamental competencies required for the entrepreneur is the ability to take initiatives. It is rather the first step in the enterprise. An entrepreneur has to be a keen observer of the society, the commercial trends, the products, types, change dynamics, and the consumer trends. Once he or she decides to take the initiative, what matters is the speed with which she is going to function. That is initiative. That is one of the most fundamental competencies is required for the entrepreneurship. is the ability to take initiative. Someone has to take the initiative, even if whatever may be the process or any whatever it is, anything. So someone should take the initiative. Then only the process will be fulfilled and it will be started. Next, creativity and innovations. The competency in creativity and innovation are sometimes basic traits of certain individuals. He or she might not have any new ideas. She maybe use the creative ideas and innovative products and services to meet the challenges of a situation. Take advantage of the utility of an idea or a product to create wealth. Example, changes in the packaging of potato chip. Next is risk taking and risk management. Even if you see the topic, risk taking and risk management itself, we wanted to know what it is, right? An entrepreneur ventures into new ideas and new things. He or she, any entrepreneur, treats to areas of uncertainty. There are several elements such as demand, supply in the market, resources availability, acceptability of the product and the service, which threw a potential challenge to the entrepreneur. In order to attune oneself in the skill of risk taking and management, he should practice in several areas of entrepreneurial functions, such as entering into new market. For example, when Dhirubhai Ambani faced cash crunch, he took the risk of issuing shares in 1977 to the public when they were not aware of the share market. Problem solving. Once an entrepreneur is aware that he has ventured on a new area and has taken certain calculated risk, he should have also be aware that Biotech Consortium India Limited, that has many problems are bound to come in the path of progress. They should understand that there is more than one way of solving. Look for alternative strategies or sources that would help to solve the problems, generate new ideas, products, services, etc. The leadership. An entrepreneur should also be an effective leader who should be able to guide and motivate his or her entire team. So the leadership is very, very important. How the leader is working, according to the followers, they will work under the guidance of leadership. Whenever a company faces a problem, it is the willpower and effective business acumen and communication skills which oversees the success of the corporation. Persistence. In most cases, the entrepreneurial pursuits are new and need very close attention. Creating a need in the market for the enterprise is one of the main requirements of the entrepreneur. This calls for intense perseverance on the part of the entrepreneur. Roadblocks to success should not deter the entrepreneur. For example, mixers when introduced did not have many customers, but today we find it to be an essential part of kitchen accessories. When Mahima Mehra brought out her product, Hathi Chop, she had experimented on various other material before using the elephant dung to manufacture handmade paper. Quality performance. The entrepreneurs value outstanding performance. One of the behavioral skills necessary is the sensitivity and concern for the standards and quality of work. One develops the skill of comparing the quality of the product which evolves or set by others. For example, Steve Jobs, the brain behind Apple and iPod, is known to value quality in all the products introduced by the company. Then I would like to tell you about what are the types of entrepreneurs. The entrepreneurs can be of different types. Some may prefer to go it alone and share the risk in groups with others. They are found in every economic systems and every form of economic activity, as well as in other social and cultural activities. They are seen from amongst farmers, laborers, fishermen, tribes, artisans, artists, importers, exporters, bankers, professionals, politicians, bureaucrats, and so many others. Based on the above features, C. Dunhoff has broadly classified entrepreneurship into four types: innovative entrepreneur, imitative entrepreneur, Fabian entrepreneur, and then drone entrepreneur. First one, that is innovative entrepreneur. In the early phases of economic development, entrepreneurs have initiative to start new venture and find innovative ways to start an enterprise. Thus, innovative entrepreneurs are those who introduce new product, new methods of production, new techniques, discovers a new market or new service, or reorganizes the enterprises. It is the innovative entrepreneur who built the modern capitalism. They are commonly found in developed countries. They are aggressive in nature, who exhibit cleverness in putting attractive possibilities into practice. Example, Walt Disney, who started a huge theme park such as the Disneyland. Next type of entrepreneur, imitative entrepreneur. The second group, they usually copy or adopt suitable innovations made by innovative entrepreneurs. That is imitative. What others are doing, they will imitate. They are adaptive and more flexible. They are organizers of factors of production rather than creators. They won't create anything new, but they will follow what others are doing. The imitative entrepreneurs are also revolutionary and important. Next, Fabian entrepreneur. The third type is the Fabian entrepreneur. They are very shy and lazy. They are very cautious. They do not venture or take risks. They are not ready to take any risk. They are rigid and fundamental in their approach. Usually, they are second generation entrepreneurs in a family business enterprise. They follow the footsteps of their predecessors. They imitate only when they are sure that failure to do so results in a loss of the relative position in the enterprise. Then drone entrepreneurs. The fourth type is the drone entrepreneur, who refuse to copy or use opportunities that come their way. They are conventional in their approach. They are not ready to make changes in their existing production methods, even if they suffer losses. They resist changes. They may be termed as laggards. Then characteristics of biotechnology industry. Medium to very long product development. It needs time. Capital intensive, highly regulated, extensive skill set and technical knowledge required. One of the most research intensive industries in the world. Entrepreneurship in the context of biotechnology. The bioentrepreneur operates in a knowledge-based and science-based industry, where competitive advantage is achieved through the effective management of intellectual property emanating from good science. The bioentrepreneur is often a scientist or become a researcher turned entrepreneur who wishes to see their research successes put into practice through commercialization. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you all.